Good afternoon, class. Today we are going to have emphasis on what is computer network. Okay, so you all tell me, what do you know about network? We say now that is all are in network. They all are connected with each other. So what is this network? Network is nothing but connection of two or more computers for sharing data, for sharing resources. Okay. So computer network is a reliability of computer resources, resource sharing between two or more computers. Okay. Now what is the requirement for network? Why network is necessary? See, till the WhatsApp social networking had come in existence, we all were surviving. But then why suddenly we all have become dependent on network? Why we have dependent on WhatsApp and other social networking sites? What is need of this network? See, the need is to share computer files. Network provides effective method for sharing files. It allows to share the computer peripheral. That is, like, suppose I have 10 computers and I want a printer. So economically, having 10 computers with 10 printers is not practically possible, economically possible. So one computer, 10 computers get connected with one printer. So there is a resource sharing. In our school, we have all the computers connected with the Xerox machine. So the teachers, those who want to give the print, they can give directly to one Xerox machine. So is it possible to have all the computers having all their own separate Xerox machine? No, it is not possible. So for sharing of the devices, network is essential. It enables communication between operating systems. Then it improves the communication speed and accuracy. It reduces cost of data transfer. Okay, data transfer cost is also reduced due to networking. Okay, now which all are the terminologies, the terms which are used in network? We call in a computer language, we call a computer in a network as a node. We say that this all nodes are connected with each other. So here node is nothing but a computer. What is server? Server is a facility provider. Server is a computer which is having all its data, all the license of the Xerox softwares, all the resources are been installed over there. For example, your Xerox, your printer, your scanner, all are been installed on the server, and from there all other client machines accesses it. So the servers are of two types: dedicated server, non-dedicated server. That means active server and non-active server. Okay, then what is network interface unit or network interface card? Now see, this network interface unit is nothing but a device which makes the computer connected with each other. So to connect the computers with each other, you require some hardware unit, that is NIU. Okay, at back of your computer you have NIC, or back of your CPU, your box, you have NIC card, that is network interface card, where you put your network cable over there. Okay, now which all are the types of network? See, these networks are categorized into different types based on geographical area. So which all are the types of network? LAN, MAN, PAN, WAN. LAN, local area network, a network formed within same building. Okay. Then MAN, a network formed within different buildings but within an same campus. Okay, multiple locations but within same peripheral area is called MAN. What is WAN? Wide area network, which is having no geographical restrictions. So the best example of WAN is your internet connecting the computers all over the world wide web is called as WAN. What is PAN? It is personal area network, sharing of internet, sharing of resources within the same unit is called as PAN. Okay. See, LAN, MAN, WAN. Now, How this network concept got developed? This network concept got developed with the American military sources, that is ARPANET. American military people, they wanted to communicate with each other. They wanted to communicate with each other, and they wanted to have a sharing with the help of computer. So the first internet concept was developed. A small network was developed by American Military Defense Computer Department, and it worked out successfully. Then they tried to expand it, and this how the internet had taken existence. See, there is no specific owner of internet. Any one of us can upload the data on internet. Any one of us can have sharing the data on internet. So some rules and regulations have been set, okay, by your Geneva World Wide Web, which decides what is vulgar, what all can get uploaded, what all should get restricted. That all has been decided. But then close कर रही ऑन कर पा रही. ओके, दैट ऑल इज बीन डिसाइडेड. नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट व्हाट इज वर्ल्ड वाइड वेब, WWW. ओके, बिफोर दैट वी विल जस्ट सी व्हाट इज इंटरनेट. व्हाट इज इंटरनेट? इंटरनेट इज अ सिंपल कंसेप्ट. इट्स अ जस्ट नेटवर्क ऑफ नेटवर्क, अ वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स नेटवर्क विच इंक्लूड्स लैन, मैन, पैन, वैन, ऑल एवरीथिंग which gets connected with each other is nothing but internet. Your all banks are in internet. Your computers, now you have phone pay, G pay, this all, everything is going on with the help of internet. Okay, so it is a complex, huge complex network. Okay, so what is WWW? World Wide Web. Okay, see, World Wide Web was developed under by Tim Berners-Lee. Okay, and it was developed under the World Wide Web Consortium in Geneva. They decided some norms, some rules and regulation to establish World Wide Web so that the websites will get displayed on internet. Okay, so to display the websites on internet, which programming language you need to learn? HTML, which you must have learned till now. CBSE students, HTML is a language which is used for designing the website. Okay, so to design a website, you require HTML. And you require a web browser. Okay, then you require URL. URL is Uniform Resource Locator, through which you get connected with the websites. So suppose I want to open a website of, say, filling online forms, government forms. So I'll enter there www.indiangovernment.com. That means www is World Wide Web. So irrespective of location, the website will get open. And which URL, what is the address of it? Indiangovernment.com. Okay, it is a domain name. .com stands for commercial. What is HTTP? You all must have seen HTTP many of a times while entering any website address. What is HTTP? HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It is nothing but the rules and regulations which you are been following knowingly, unknowingly while accessing the websites on internet. Okay. Now we will turn towards which all are the terminologies which we use at the time of networking. Terminologies like data transfer rate. We say now sometimes the speed is very slow, sometimes the speed is very high. So that is bit by bit the data. Suppose I want to send one photograph to my friend. So that photo gets cut down into thousands of small units, small bits, and each bit is packed with the sender's and receiver's address and the packet number. Okay, and like a jigsaw puzzle, that bits all get thrown out on internet. So randomly the packets are been received by the receiver. Now at the receiver side, there is a demodulator. There is a modulator, a demodulator. So at the receiver size, these all packets which were thrown randomly will get assembled like a jigsaw puzzle, and one photo gets formed. And finally, that photo is been displayed at the receiver. So the speed which is been taken to send each of this packet is called as data transfer rate. What is bandwidth? Bandwidth is the range or frequency between which a communication system works. So it is nothing but the frequency, the unit of measuring the frequency of the data channel. What is BPS? That is bits per second. How many bits of data, this how many small packets of data per second are being sent, is called BPS. What is baud? It is actually a common measurement unit for data transfer rate, baud. Okay, what is data channel? A channel means the flow of data or to carry the data from one device to another. Suppose I am sitting here, next to my chair other teacher is sitting, and I am just sharing one photo with the teacher. So I am sharing the photo with the help of internet. Now from my mobile, the data will get sent into air, through air channel, through air medium, the data will get catched by their mobile, and then their mobile decoder will convert, will make the complete image of that picture, and finally she will be seeing that. So data channel can be any medium through which the data flows. It can be wired, it can be wireless. In the next unit, we'll be seeing the channels. Okay, so here students, we are done with the basics of network. What is network? Which all are the types of network? Need of network? Terminologies of network? Okay, then how the network got established, form? What is internet? World Wide Web? Okay, data communication terminologies. So we will stop over here. What you need to do is go through it, go through the textbook. If you have any difficulty, please do share with me. In our next lecture, we will be continuing with the same topic, the next half part. Okay, have a good day. Take care.